First of all, I want to kind of take this time to get to know who you are and the Outlaws, because a lot of people know you through, of course, Tupac Shakur, the group, the Outlaws, and all of that. But we kind of want to get into your background a little bit and kind of go from there. So if you can kind of tell me, what was your background and upbringing, so to speak? And I know you were born in California, is that correct?
Yeah, I was born in L.A. I was raised in Jersey, Montclair, and Orange, New Jersey. And, you know, just grew up, you know, normal hood story, man. You know what I mean? Hustling at a young age. I've been on my own since, like, I was, like, 13. You know what I mean? You know, moms were strung out. Big bro was strung out. You know, all that kind of shit. But, you know, I was always a smart dude. So you know, even though I was hustling and doing that, when I went to school, you know, I was excellent at whatever I was focused on at the time. And, you know, I got with Pac from Gaddafi. I grew up with Gaddafi. That's Pac's half-brother. Rest in peace. He passed away as well, you know, November 10th, 96, you know, a couple months after Pac passed. You know, I grew up with him in Jersey, you know what I mean? And, you know, that's how I got introduced to Pac through him, you know what I mean?
Okay, yeah, no doubt we're going to get into that a little bit, too. Okay, wow, didn't know that. Very interesting, and congratulations and much respect to you for staying on that right path and being able to join us here today on the show, because I don't know that many people that can come out of that situation and have a positive outlook on life and the future and all of that. So you can do nothing but respect that.
Yeah, I'm blessed, man. You know, honestly, you know, between my mom and my brother, you know, they gave me great examples of what I didn't want to become. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So it was like, you know, getting locked up and, you know, going back and forth to the youth house and, you know, just dealing with the street shit and the homies start, you know, getting killed and all that. You know, I changed my life. I was like, you know, I got to get out of this shit. Once I made that decision to actually leave and go back to Cali, you know, that's when I got introduced to the rap game. It was just like, you know, it was just fake. It was just like one day I was just like, you know what, I'm tired of this shit. Got the fuck out of there. A couple months after that, I was in the rap game with, you know, the greatest rapper of all time. You know what I mean?
You know, I just really respect the fact that you were doing your schooling and that at the same time. It takes a lot. So then, tell me, describe that experience to me then when you did get an opportunity to meet Pac. I'm sure you already knew who he was and all what he had going on at the time. How was that experience for you?
It was a blessing, you know what I mean? You know, I was going to school and, you know, when Pac got out of jail, you know, he brought the first two Outlaws he brought to L.A. was Gaddafi and Fatal. And them is dudes that I grew up with in Jersey since, like, second and third grade, you know what I mean? And, you know, the whole hood knew that I had left a couple months prior and went out there. So as soon as they got out there, they called me and shit. So I got home from school one day and, you know, my sister was like, Gaddafi and Fatal called you. They said they out here. So I called them. They like, yeah, we out here with Pac. I'm like, what? And I knew he had just got out of jail. He had just got out of jail maybe like a week before that shit. So, you know, he brought them out there and, you know, they like, we out here. So I'm like, I'm coming out there and shit. So, you know, I start going out there with them on the weekend and still going to school, you know what I mean? And, you know, one day Pac, you know, after maybe about a month, he was like, yo, move out here with it. You know what I'm saying? But I was going to do the clothesline. Like, I was young, fresh, dirty. I was a little flavor, you know what I mean? So he was like, yo, we need to start this Outlaw clothing line. He's like, yo, you need money for this. So, you know, he basically told me, like, yo, you need to come out here, drop out of school, come out here and get some money. So this was all before he even heard me rap. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So, you know, I'm coming out there, you know, I'm you know, just on some soulsy shit. You know, I was young, but I was grown than a motherfucker, you know what I mean? Black hair, you know what I mean? Holding pistols. I was just on some soulsy shit, really. And, you know, I had a notebook full of rhymes, though. Like, I wasn't even thinking, like, yo, I want to be in the group or any of that shit. But when I finally rapped for him, you know, he was basically mad. Like, yo, you been around this whole time and didn't rhyme for me? Like,
right.
You know, opposite. And his level of respect shot through the roof for me. Because, you know, usually dudes, you walking out, you know, we in a mall and 20 dudes would come up wanting to rap for him. So,
right.
Here I am living with the nigga and he don't even know I rhyme. I got a whole book of rhyme, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So, like, my Hail Mary rhyme, I wrote that before I was even in the Outlaws, you know what I'm saying? Like, I had a whole book of rhymes. So, when I finally rhymed for him and shit, you know, he was like, yo, you dope. He was like, let me hear some more shit. So, I grabbed my notebook and I rhymed for him for about an hour, man. And he was like, yo, that's it. You the last member, man. You know, I was number seven, the last member. So I was gonna be the first solo artist. Like before he died, he was about to sign a deal with Quest Records. You know what I mean? And I was gonna be the first solo outlaw to come out. You know what I mean? So dude, a lot of faith in me, man. You know what I mean?
Absolutely. I mean, your story is amazing. Just thus far, and then like I said, that's just respecting you as a business fan. You're on your business, handling this thing. You didn't bum rush me. I always tell artists, do not hit these people up like that. It's not the proper time. It's the proper place for the networking and promo and all that. It seems like you kind of figured all that out before it was even popular to know, you know, the injury.
It just happened like that. Like, I didn't, you know what I mean? When I went back out there, I was just rhyming every day. I was just writing every day, but... You know, I was going to school. I was like, I'm trying to get me a great job and have a steady income. I wasn't like, I want to be a fucking rapper. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know, I was just around on some soldier shit. But, you know, he obviously thought I was real dope. And he was like, yo, we about to get through a solo deal and you the last member of the group. And that's it. You know what I mean? But, you know, and then, you know, the crazy shit is, it's like, you know, all the songs we recorded, you know, he was, you know, him and Gaddafi passed away before any song that we recorded together even came out. Machiavelli was the first CD that I was featured on. That came out after him and Gaddafi was deep, you know what I mean? So it's like my whole entry into the game has been like, you know, I never really got to enjoy this shit from the beginning, you know what I'm saying? Even to this day. You know, I got a house full of platinum plaques. And it's like, you know, I never really got a chance to enjoy it because my niggas was gone before it even hit the street. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, it's been a crazy ride, man. But, you know, we outlaws, man. And I guess it was never meant to be easy for us, you know?
Yeah, I can relate and I can dig it. I mean, they say if it was easy, everybody be doing it. And one thing, I grew up with this, your music, y'all's music, all of that. I mean, it was awesome.
As far as the Outlaws and Pop, we made like a huge impact. And
yes, you did.
Let me just say one thing. We made a huge impact from all the music we recorded in less than a year.
Here on the documentary, something that we haven't seen on the internet, just something personal or something that, you know, you could share with the audience and everybody that's listening tonight, one of your cherished moments.
You put me on the spotlight. Let me think of something y'all might not know. I don't know, man. You had to ask me something specific. You know what I mean? Like, I can't just
okay, how about on tour? How about on tour, on stage, at a concert? One of the most craziest times, experiences you guys all had.
You know what, man? Every day was crazy. You know, I remember one time we went to a concert. It was like R. Kelly's concert in L.A., man. And I remember when the concert was over, you know, we were standing, like, you know, in the crowd, like, towards the front. You know what I mean? Pop, you know, him and Kel was cool, man. So we went down there and shit, and I remember they cut the lights on. And this is a big amphitheater. Like, it might have been, like, 20,000 people there or something. You know what I mean? This is in L.A. I forgot where it was at, but one of them spots, and I just remember the whole audience was like, oh, they're gonna pop. And it was like, you know, us, we the Outlaws, we ain't had no all these security with us. It's us. Mind you, we all was young. I was and it was like, I wasn't used to this shit. I'm from Jersey.
Right.
Like, you know, all these eyes on us. It's like, I'm like, yo, man, we, you know what I mean? But the whole fucking crowd surrounded us and followed us outside, just saying, like just going crazy over this guy. Like, they literally had the car surrounded probably for about 45 minutes, man. Like, Pac had to stand on top of the car and just cut, like, beg these people, like, please, like, just let us go.
Oh, my goodness.
But it was love, though. It wasn't like, you know, they didn't want us or nothing. But
no.
I was just like, you know, when that shit, I was just like, man, this guy's a living legend.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, in the flesh, walking around. You know what I mean? So it was just like, it's just too many stories, man. Like, every day, there was a story. No doubt about it. It was something was going to happen. You know what I mean? That was just,
right.
That was just the nature of, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, I can't thank you enough just for coming through real quick tonight and
no
chit chat with me. I actually want to bring you back for a full interview with fans calling in and commenting and all of that. You got a lot of crazy fans too, and I want them all to call in and speak with you when you get ready to drop this album.
Just reach out when you're ready and let's get it done, and I appreciate you.